And if you be faithful, you be sweet, and I'll be grateful. Cover me with kisses, dear. Lighten up the atmosphere. Keep me warm inside our bed. I got dreams of you all through my head. Fortune teller said I'd be free, and that's the day you came to me.
Have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
We have.
We have.
Yes, we have. Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes,
yes, we will.
Good. Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and His church?
Yes, we will.
I, Stephen, take you, Lindsay, to be my lawful wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do us part.
I, Lindsay, take you, Stephen, for my lawful husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do us part.
Lindsay, take this ring.
Lindsay, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Stephen, take this ring.
Stephen, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Face forward.
Promise you won't hold me down. Oh, when we reach a good place, let's be sure to leave no trace. Promise they won't track us down.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of
good job. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Congratulations.
Good, good. How are you?
Hey, Steve and Lindsay. Good job. Everything worked out perfect.
Congratulations.
Steve, Lindsay. Congratulations. We're so happy.
Are you practicing your speech? All right, good.
Congratulations.
My groom's brother!
Right.
Brother.
Oh.
I love my brother.
She did it. She did it.
This is a very, very happy moment, peppered in sadness.
Oh. Anyway, the thing is, what I really mean, your eyes are the sweetest eyes I've ever seen. And you can tell everybody this is a song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, I hope you don't mind, I hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is now you're in the world. I was a sculptor, but then again, no. Or a girl who makes potions. dancing, a traveling show. I know it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you.
Everyone, please please rise at this time. If you're not standing, I won't ask you to please stand. Please stand, everybody. Can I get everybody to make a little bit of noise out there? There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, I want a big, big round of applause. Put your hands together nice and loud. Let's hear for our beautiful bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Steve and Lindsay Stankovich. Try and please me. You never let me down before. Ooh, don't imagine you're too familiar. I don't see you anymore. Put your hands together for everybody. Come on, let's hear it. Never could have come this far. I took the good times, take the bad times, take you just the way you
Well, good evening. Thank you for joining us in celebrating the marriage of Lindsay and Steve. Shh. Thank you. This event has been in the works for about a year and a half, and I have to thank Lindsay and Sandra for the great job they did. A round of applause. I'd like to say a special thanks to my longtime friend, Father Charlie Guzmer, and Monsignor Robert Slipe for officiating our Mass today, which was an awesome job, and thank you very much for doing what you did for us. We have attendees from all around the world here with us today, along with a very large group from Seattle, Steve's family. And my sister Adrienne, whose family came from Colorado to join us. We appreciate that. Thanks, guys. And we have relatives and friends from all around the world, actually, in many states and countries. So thank you for joining us on this special day. And now a very, very special thanks for Dorothy and Pete for sharing Steve with us. We greatly appreciate that. He's a great addition to our family. And now, Lindsay, it's your turn. Yeah, when Lindsay was just 3 years old, I remember her jumping on a two-wheel bicycle with training wheels and her saying, you know, get these training wheels off. And I turned to Sandra and said, we're in trouble. And that's probably where it all began, Lindsay. One time when Lindsay was about 15 years old and she wasn't getting her way, she decided to run away to Covenant House in New York City, which is a runaway home, if you don't know. And when she saw her accommodations was not what she was accustomed to, all of a sudden home wasn't that bad. But I'll tell you, she put us through an ordeal that night. We never knew where this segment of life was going, but your parents will understand. Glad you came back, Lindsay. Lindsay's motto has been for a very long time, fear is temporary, regret is forever. So when she told us that the news that she wanted to really travel the country by herself, travel the world actually by herself for 18 months, we weren't totally surprised. But during her travel, she came across a diamond in the rough, Steve. Steve is a great guy. Steve was living in Seattle at the time and was traveling through Australia. They met in a little town called York, and the rest is history. Steve, we love you. You accept her, thank you very much. You're keeping her, thank you very much. Steve is truly a great guy, and Lindsay, you had a good catch there. Anyway, that's so much for what I wrote down for you. I just want you to know that Lindsay is a very special person, special to me, and she knows that. We're raised, I guess, to think of our children as someone we have to teach all our life. But I can tell you, I learned a lot from Lindsay. She told me a lot about her dreams, her passion, her self-esteem, not sweating the small stuff, and really just choosing your battles. And I've learned a lot, Lindsay, and thank you. I love you. And Sandra, thank you.
Oh, I could share a few stories as the mother. But I will keep it short and sweet. Just one quick thing. She was like 5 years old, and I just remember this tonight. She was going off to kindergarten. It was her first day of kindergarten, and she came back, and she had her book bag full of these forms that you have to fill out, you know, when they come back from the first day of school. And she put them on a table, and she said, fill these out. And I said, okay, just leave them there, I'll do it. No, fill them out right now. And I had to do it right now so that she could go in her book bag the next day. And this is what I had to deal with for the next 33 years. And that's only one of many stories that I could share. But Lindsay, you certainly made our life very creative, and you brought us to places that we never thought we were going to be. And Steve, all I can say is you are going to have a very exciting life. So buckle your seatbelt, sir. Thank you all for coming. We really appreciate it. Have a great time. Oh, and by the way, there's pictures outside. There's a photo booth. Take as many as you want. So get in groups, get in couples or whatever. There's also going to be flip-flops out there if your feet start hurting later on. So just enjoy yourself and don't get too tired because there's an after party, which is going to be really a lot of fun. So make sure you save some energy for that. Have a great time. Enjoy yourselves, guys. I held her first,
and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. And I prayed that she'd find you someday, but it's still hard to keep her away, 'cause I love her first. How could that beautiful woman with you be the same freckle-faced kid that I knew, the one that I read all those fairy tales to and tucked into bed all those nights? I knew the first time I saw you with her, it was only a matter of time. But I loved her first, and I knew the first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew the love of a father runs deep. Someday I might know what I'm going through when a miracle smiles up at you, 'cause I loved it first.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big, big round of applause for a very proud dad here this evening. Beautiful, guys. Very nice. Awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you all to put your hands together for a proud, very proud mom here this evening. Yeah, mama.
I see a tree. It's a green. Red roses, too. I see them blue. Both me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Oh yeah. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. The bright blessed day. Oh, those dark sacred nights. And I think to myself, oh, what a wonderful world. Give it up, give it up. Oh, I think to myself, oh, what a wonderful world.
Beautiful, guys. Very, very nice.
I feel so close to you right now. It's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love pours down on me, surround me like a waterfall. There's no stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now. stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now. Stopping us right now, and there's no stopping us right now, and there's no stopping us right now.
If there's anyone here who is feeling worried, nervous, or apprehensive right now, you're either me or just married Steve Stankovich. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Joe Stankovich, one of Steve's brothers, page two. These past couple days have been absolutely amazing, from the rehearsal dinner to the wedding and now to this celebration. Everything is just absolutely gorgeous. Really first class all the way. I'd like to thank Sandra and Richard, as well as my mom and dad, for helping putting these past couple days all together. And thank you. Page three. And Steve, just want to say you did real good. Not only do you have a new beautiful wife, but you added an incredible set of parents to your new family. To Steve and Lindsay. Oh, and Steve, I almost forgot this next song the band's playing for us. So it's Luther Vandersong. If you'd meet me out here on the dance floor. No, I'm just kidding.
Hello, I'm going digital. Sorry, guys. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Lindsay's first cousin, Courtney. Our mothers are sisters. Lindsay and I grew up as close as possible, spending every summer together at our grandparents' house after we went to drama camp. And if you know me and Lindsay, that might explain some things. We have a flair for the dramatic. I grew up with Lindsay sharing so many amazing experiences throughout our life. We're a year and a half apart and amazing, and Lindsay was always quite the adventurer. I was always a little bit of a scaredy cat. I got a lot of, don't be a chicken, Courtney. And, you know, it was that sense of adventure that led her across the pond and then even farther, and that helped her find you. And, you know, I think everything in life happens for a reason, and I truly believe that you two are soulmates. I'm an old school romantic, and I believe in soulmates. And I think that you really do complete each other. My Lindsay is a firecracker. Just like the firecrackers you had tonight. Every day is a new adventure. And Steve, you're calm, cool, collected, and the kindest person on earth, truly. And I couldn't imagine a more perfect complement to each other. So, Lindsay, I love you with all my heart. No matter where we've been in the globe, we managed to find each other, visiting each other anywhere we are. And I love you forever. You are like, I'm an only child. You're the closest thing I've ever had to a sister. We're opposites in so many ways, but we complete each other. So, Steve, welcome to our family. I wish you the most amazing continuation of this journey together. And remember, laughter is the best medicine. Nothing is ever that serious. And the best is yet to come. I love you both, and congratulations.
Guys, I'm very happy to be here tonight, and I just have to say that this is a very magical moment for me, and you know, for her to find somebody like Steve has just been amazing. And I got to say that knowing my sister growing up, it's been it's been quite amazing. This girl's done so much for me, I can't even tell you. She showed up at my college and done my English term papers for me. I mean, it's honestly no joke. It's unbelievable. And she's gone out of her way for me in so many different ways. And putting aside the fact that I shot an arrow in her eye and chipped a couple teeth, our relationship has been, you know, the best friendship I've ever had. And being here tonight to have her find someone that's been equally as great of a friend as Steve, can't tell you, it's been really amazing. But, you know, the night that she called me one night and she was like, you know, I'm down in Thailand, or no, I'm in Australia. And this guy that just lost his visa had to go back to Thailand, and she really didn't know what to do and whether she should go and go see him again. I was like, you know what, tell me a little bit more about this. And she's like, you know what, yeah, you know, this guy, he's just really great, and he just lost his visa, and you know, what should I do? And I just stopped. And I said, go get him. So I have to say, I take credit for all you people being here tonight, because this is because of me. This happened. That's all I gotta say. Steve, welcome to the family. I love you. You know that? Thank you. Thanks, guys.
Great job, guys. Once again, everybody, put your hands together. Let's hear for Joe, Courtney, and Rick. They did such a great job. Give it up for them.
Stephen, take you, Lindsay, to be my lawful wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do us part.
I, Lindsay, take you, Stephen, for my lawful husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do us part.
Her jumping on a two-wheel bicycle with training wheels and her saying, you know, get these training wheels off. And I turned to Sandra, I said, we're in trouble.